do a lot of warps, which gets consistent spawns. For a comparable time, I think my time ends up being slower, but it's more consistent. I used to do it the other method, where you kind of like chase him up the valley, the dragon. But it was not consistent, and it wasn't that fast. We'll go back to doing it purely the same way we used to. Memory first, then activate the shrine. Then if we have an early Dinral spawn, then we shoot the scale and then hit the fountain. If not, then set a campfire and do warps between each dragon part. I got this. I know what I'm doing.
Let's go!
But Dinral's really the one that's like the biggest pain. Like Nadra, I like this new method. It's alright. It's not as fast as my method, but you end up higher up on the mountain. Which I like, because you save a ton of time getting to Akala. I was doing a BLS from the tech lab, and I would warp back later to do Nadra, so it was definitely slower the other way. Happy to have some splits to compare to, though. This will be way better than the last one, just for that reason alone. I would guess I have 5 minutes of time save at Dinral, maybe more, maybe six. So EB is very possible with this route. Six minutes of time save, and the last run was only 45 seconds behind.
Dirige-toi vers le lieu que t'indique la carte de la tablette Sheikah.
It's not 6 minutes overall, it's 6 minutes just in that one section alone, so pick up more time elsewhere as well. Plateau! I'm out of water. I should have refilled my water when I was on my break. Oh well. Didn't think about the water. In there. Not as fast as the last one, but it's a fine stasis. Stasis and Cryo went really well in the last run. Mag and bombs were both not ideal. Hits, hello! Nice to see you, friend. I'm doing okay. Just messing around in this niche category. Maxed Champion's Tunic. Hoping to get a PB before the end of the stream. Which is very possible because of some route changes we have been working on. It's good to see you. How are you being? Oh yeah. Zoom in. In there. Another really good cryo. Oh boy. Phone freaked out. Oh, welcome back. Isn't technology just the greatest? I've never had that guardian like block me right there. Explosion point max tunic will tell you about the category. We get the champion's tunic, which requires one memory, and then you talk to Impa, and then you upgrade it to full, which means you need to pay off all 4 fairy fountains and what am I doing? And collect parts from every dragon. Horns, two horns from each dragon. It's a very niche category that is not done by many people. That looks good. Oh, it's fairly low. Yeah, I like that we get to free Nadra. That's cool. Not a lot of runs other than Hundo do that. I grabbed that stick on purpose, I do need it. I also like the rupee duping. I think I really like runs with really technical glitches, and that's pretty technical. It used to kind of intimidate me, but as I've done it more, I've gotten used to it. We exploit an NPC for infinite gems at a stable. So there's a part of the run where we just kind of mash A for 4 minutes and get rich. It's cool. Yeah, it's really challenging. Which I like. I've been focused on this run for a couple months, it feels like now. I don't know, since BLS was discovered, which was the beginning of last month. So, 2 months now. I am kind of ready to move on, but I do want that world record, and it is within reach. I just need to have a good run where the dragons cooperate with me. Decided I want this instead of the luminous stone deposits. Since I don't have a hammer, they're kind of a pain to grab. This ruby is much more consistent. So in that section, I just need to grab the sun shrooms and then just launch out of there. It'll be way cleaner. I think that's still an improvement over the last one. Had a bad BTB angle on the last one. So, hi Jason. What do we have here? A little bit of max tunic. The bot's a little late saying hi to you. You come in and say something other than hi, hello, or hey, the bot that won't have noticed that you arrived. Which is maybe a problem. Maybe it just needs to say hey on your first message of the day. I don't know. Small improvement. This would be a better plateau. Knock on wood, because we're not done plateau yet. Hurt the bot's feelings. Don't worry, the bot has no feelings. It has no heart. It has no soul. I wouldn't worry about things like that. Yo, ZSR, thank you for the raid. Welcome in, guys. Was it a 90% race today? Who was racing? Advantages to living in the future. Now you can... Thank you for the 79 bits, Jason. Appreciate it. Yep, we got a gold. Well, this is only my second run, so save your bits. Because there'll be a lot of golds. Second run of the route. I made some changes to the route. There were three races in a row. Holy crap. Hope they were exciting. Welcome in, everybody. We're doing a maxed champion's tunic. Trying to get the world record. Hopefully. If everything goes according to plan. Appreciate the raid. Cool. 1628. That's a heckin' plateau. Ooh, I lag stopped. Usually that doesn't happen. Right there. It was a little bit too aggressive on the lag induction. I don't even really need a super launch there, so... Not sure why I did that. It does seem like a while since you've given bits or even like been around. Not seen very much of Jason, and I've missed him. All right, so we already have a ruby, which means we don't need to get gems at Satori Mountain. We just need two sun shrooms, and then we go up to the durians as usual. I guess three sun shrooms might be more safe. I don't know how many you need to get the 2x boost, but there's plenty of sun shrooms there. Oh, Hits, if you haven't been around much, you may not have seen this glitch yet. Have you seen this yet? This is new. It is quite fast. You don't have the slightest idea how it works? Hey, I don't either. I know how to do it. No idea how it works. Wasn't there another one here? There. No stamina use, yeah. No stamina, no damage. You can't eat while you do it, which is a little bit awkward. Compared to, you know, being used to eating constantly whenever you can in this game. No matter what. Eight, maybe a bit more wood. For safety, we got a little bit extra wood. Whoa. That angle, like that. I maybe wasn't paying attention to my direction there. Oops. Right here, using when things don't load in. Ours? No. Oh, they're here. Favorite places in Hyrule? Yeah, man, mine too. It's like a little grocery store for speedrunners. You get everything you need. Saved some time. Let's save like 30 seconds. 25. That's pretty good. I was just not getting the luminous stones. With bombs, which I didn't want to get them with bombs anyway. That would have been silly. That bird just pushed me. It's okay, but... kinda changed my position a bit. So these multi-shot bows will come into play when we are duping rupees later. That setup was a little bit awkward, but it was faster than the last one, so. Last one, I messed it up like 4 or 5 times. We'll save time here as well. To the castle to get shock arrows and a royal guard's weapon, more things that are used to dupe rupees later. That's all the early game is just preparing for that. Bomb wiggle dance, yeah. That's what I call it. The bomb wiggle dance. Little butt wiggles. Struggled a little here last time too. On Link. Here we go. Oh wow, we saved a lot of time on that one. Yeah, like I said, the BLS just took me a long time to get last time. Got a hankering for some Breath of the Wild. Yeah, why don't you try learning this glitch? Fun to do once you know how to do it. Not hard. Like a lot of the other speedrun glitches are. This pump. You need to go all over the place. I don't think it's possible to skip Paya here. I'd have to get really lucky. Or do like a midair into, like out of the BLS into the town. I don't know. I've just admitted defeat because I need that bow, so.
Hello.
We'll talk to Impa or Paya. Not a big deal.
On peut dire que tu as pris ton temps, n'est-ce pas, Link? Certes, j'ai bien vieilli depuis notre dernière rencontre, mais tu me reconnais, j'espère.
No, wrong thing, I'm thinking. Wish I'd refilled my water bottle on my break. My mouth is getting dry. I'm thirsty. Just eat that. Trying to like save the durian as though it's super valuable. This? Yes. This? Yes. There, Link. Up. Nope. Come on. Bill Wirtz. I love him. I should make some sound alerts out of some of his new songs. I have been really liking his new material. Hell yeah, hits. Do it. Yo. Okay, I'm gonna need to focus for about a minute here while I set up this glitch, but then it's 4 minutes of chillin'. I forgot to switch weapons ahead of time. That's my bad. So I have my weapons desynced now. There. Thank you for the follow. That wasn't too bad. I kind of messed it up at the beginning, but. We're back. Hello. Okay, now we just chill for 4 minutes and a bit, and we get unlimited money. Well. Limited only by the time we spend doing it. Getting the coin. So what we don't want here, and it's purely RNG, we don't want topaz. We want as many ruby sapphire as possible, which it seems like we're getting a lot. Because topaz are worth less, so they will make this take longer. Usually I just try to judge, like, oh, am I getting a lot of topaz? And if so, I just, like, do a couple extra cycles at the end. That's all the strategy is. Other than that, it's just setting a timer at the beginning and mashing A. I used to count each one, but even that's not really, not unless I'm doing the math on the topaz as I go, it's not even really worth it. I keep seeing a flash of white on the screen, I wonder what that is. Maybe it's to do with my camera angle. Just line it up so we can run straight for Beetle afterwards. Ready, I lined up. Make a beeline for him. Not getting a ton of topaz. This is actually really, really good. Thanks for the follow.
Yeah, this is good.
It's the most boring part, though, of the run. It's just nothing. Just chill.
Ah!
Surely we're gonna be done soon. I think. We're getting a lot of topaz at the end there. Here. I think it still should be fine. Stop. Alright, last one.
Hey! Wow!
Nice to meet you, Beetle. Need a few more gems. Too bad.
Yeah.
A little bit of a waste of time, but.
Wow.
Now you can eat some money.
Still gold. Now we got all the money we need for the run. Just gotta zoom. Wish for good luck on dragon spawning and stuff like that. Wait, shoot. I was confused. We're not going to Impa right now. We haven't even seen Fura yet. Ooh, that wind bomb sucked. Go back to the shrine and try that wind bomb again. Didn't get the height I wanted on it. No! I'm safe for next time. Not everything can go perfectly. Come on. What is this? Supposed to get a ton of height there. Get up onto that ledge. so that'll lose time, but we're still in pretty good shape. We have a split later with like 6 minutes of time saved, so I'm not worried about it. Oh yeah, the RNG blast emote is no more. They have retired that because the man being depicted in it turned out to be a creep. Same thing, almost the exact same thing that happened with the PogChamp emote. It's almost like making emotes of real people is a problem. Good call, removing creeps. Yeah, I mean, good for Twitch for being on top of that stuff, but like, that shouldn't happen in the first place. Alright, how much time did I lose with that? A lot. 2 minutes. How often it comes right down to like one wind bomb not working out right? Can't say I'm surprised. Not behind. Still in the green. Focus on the positives. Now let's go free nature. That's fine. Oh. Up here is so tough sometimes. Other times it's like piece of cake. I love this quest so much. Or, it's not a quest, but I like this sequence. I like this thing that happens in this game. Chill. Nature's chill. Your favorite quest is my favorite quest that isn't a quest. It isn't. It's just what you do to get a scale. You can get scales elsewhere, so it's not needed. It's not part of the shrine quest. You don't need to do it to do the shrine quest. You just need to drop the scale for the shrine quest. You can get a scale from Hyrule Castle. Yes, it is intended, but it's, I don't know. It's just a weird thing, I guess. Yeah, I'm surprised by that too. It really feels like it should be a quest. Did that hit this tail, the horn? That doesn't look like it's a horn. Well, that was a horn. Note to self, ear counts as horn. I mean, I wasted time going down there to do it because I need to be up here, but I have to be sure that I'm getting this a horn. Wait. A little lost. There it is. That's gonna lose me time.
Okay. All right, Tuakala. Going over that waterfall gives me flashbacks to when I used to do mid-air wind bombs all the way to Akala in this category. Thank you, Coolbot. Thank you for reporting in. Everything's normal. Saving a couple seconds. So, Dinroll can seriously save 6 minutes. Let's hope for the best there. This run is not over. Vlad, thank you for the good luck. Nice to see you.
Just wish I could make some music.
Hope you're having a good day. Making some music, maybe. Perhaps. I'm going to lose time on Tabantha Fairy, actually. Because I'm going to do these things in a slightly different order. Oh, I didn't go to Impa. It says clearly on my splits I need to go to Impa. So there's another reason why I'm going to lose time. I just warped to the wrong place. Day's been alright. That's good. Yeah, because the memory won't be there if we don't talk to Impa right here now. That's why we have to do it first. That's why I put Impa right there on my splits, so I can see that, like, this needs to be done here. And I overlooked it. Just too busy thinking about the next thing. We're wiggling. Still trying to do the manipulating the camera angle thing to get Dinryl to maybe spawn here. Didn't seem to have worked. Maybe the camera angle has nothing to do with it and it's just pure luck. That was just a theory anyway. Losing time here because I'm, well, because of the warp, but also I'm grabbing the memory in a different order, so. Again, I see, what's his name? Farosh up in the mountains, which makes me think that that's the reason why Dinryl doesn't spawn in the canyon, if that makes sense. And have two dragon spawns so close to each other at the same time. Oh boy. Fingers crossed. Dinryl goes okay. And we save 5 minutes here. Sorry, lady, I don't have any clothes. I'm completely naked. Please let me leave. There's a few places you can get Dinryl to spawn. This place is the most convenient for me for Dinryl because of Fairy Fountain and the memory. Dragon's here. A little worried there for a sec. Alright, so this first piece is a scale that we don't need. So what I do is shoot it. Yes. Yeah. Wait for the arcs to land on the ground and then warp to the shrine. So now the next piece that comes off that dragon is definitely going to be a horn. Well, depends where I shoot it. If I hit it in the horn, it'll be a horn. super launch every time. Still get to the dragon even without it, but super launches are faster. One horn. One more horn, and then we'll have saved 4 minutes, maybe? Wasn't really what I was hoping for. I was hoping like 6, but... Okay, so that's like 5 minutes. Nice. It could have been faster because we could have gotten a earlier spawn, like on our way to the memory. You can have her spawn there, but other than that, it was pretty good. 6 minutes is good for Denril. Yeah, I came up with that because I wasn't liking the inconsistency of some of the other methods. In that area, anyway. Rosh is usually pretty easy. The only really bad thing that can happen is that the horns land on opposite sides of the lake. Just a pain. But not this problem. Sometimes that happens with campfires here. I'm not really sure why. See what I mean? They just don't light. Need my... I need to come back. I didn't see where that first horn landed. Over there. No, I keep getting a dead angle. It's like... There. That will not be a dead angle. Nice, safe wind bomb. Get me to the horn, please. Thank you. Jeez, game. Gerudo Fairy. Yeah. Not much else can go wrong in this run, though. I think this is a PB / world record. Safe to say at this point. We've done all the hard parts. It's just kind of clean up now. Get to the last two great fairies. Get the tunic. From this fountain, just double checking that I'm getting the right flowers. Lost a couple seconds to whatever. One more fairy, pick up the tunic. I don't know. I wish I hadn't lost all that time. On my way to Bantha Fairy was pretty bad, and then on my way to Hateno was pretty bad. Other than that, this run was solid, I guess. I'll be satisfied with the next one. How's that?
Oh.
Yeah, it's just the 2 minutes that I lost just, like, getting up to the BLS spot on my way to Hateno was just unfortunate. I was super ahead, and then I was, like, not super ahead, and that doesn't feel good. World record, though, I think. What's Nookie's time exactly? I need to double check. I'm pretty sure my previous PB was only like 45 seconds behind. Is. Okay, coming up to the time, and 1:20m40s. Hits was, so the current world record is 1:22:02. There we go. About a 2 minute record.